I would say, I look at the words of Jesus to the church of Philadelphia, and he says, I've set before you an open door, no man can shut it. So the doors of our buildings are closed temporarily, but the doors for the church have never been more open. Listen, the church is not closed, it's deployed. Mm-hmm. Jesus did not say the whole world should go to church. He said the church should go to the whole world. And like Andy, you know, I believe that we're still going to have a brick and mortar church. We're going to open our building up in time. And we're a lot of pastors I know, we're all talking about this with each other. But we're in this space right now where we're reaching more people than we've ever reached before all around the world. And I think it's been a really great time for a lot of us to grow up spiritually. But also I think for leaders, because I know you have pastors that watch this, and this is a moment to adapt. You know, here's how I'm looking at it. I'd love to hear Andy's thoughts on this as well. But I'm looking at our church now as a startup church. I've been pastoring for 45 years. I'm starting all over again.
My goodness.
And so I have a blank sheet of paper. And the new normal is not going to be like the old normal. And I don't want the new normal to be like the old normal. I want to relook at everything and get down to what are the things that are really important to us. And I don't think, I think up for us, honestly, it was like our main focus was on our physical buildings and our people before us, and we did something online as well. Now that's shifted. This online thing is a big thing. Television has always been a big thing, of course, but I think we're all gonna take it seriously. And you know, Andy, I'd be interested in your thoughts, but if you are not pivoting right now, it can be the end of your ministry. You have to pivot in the moment. I bet you're talking to a lot of pastors who are asking you, maybe they're getting into, you know, televising thing or putting things on camera. What are your thoughts and advice for those guys?
What you just said just affirms a conversation we had earlier this week. We have 9 or 10 churches in the Atlanta area and then a network outside of the Atlanta area. And I said to our team this week, I said, you know what, as we think about getting back into our buildings, we should approach this as if we are church planting, as if we're starting all over. And you know what? I felt so, again, it was a Zoom call. So how much energy is there on a Zoom call? But I actually felt, maybe for the first time, some energy on a Zoom call around, because we love starting things. Greg, you love starting things. We love planning things. And it is easy to get into the routine of here comes Sunday, here comes Sunday, here comes Sunday. So I said to our team, when we open, let's not think of just reopening all of our environments. Let's think in terms of starting over, because there is so much to take away during this season. And, you know, pain without gain is a real shame, right? I mean, if there's going to be pain, there needs to be gain, or we've wasted the pain. So to rush back to normal, and this is, and you know, to your general audience, this is true for us personally. I think every Christian hopefully learn something financially through this. Wow. They've learned something relationally through this. They've learned something in terms of their faith. And so for those of your audience out there who their faith has taken a hit because they didn't have a version of faith that could hold up under something like a pandemic, they're looking in the mirror asking, hey, is there a God, but have I had the wrong perspective on my own faith? So at every level, we should all be better for it. But in order to be better for it, we've got to pause, take a few notes before we rush back to normal, because when things start getting back to normal, the tendency is to, you know, it's like after you give your dog a bath, what does the dog do? Shakes and heads back outside to get back in the dirt. So we cannot make that mistake. This has been too painful not to make some great gains.